Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Three men have been charged in connection with the disappearance and death of a young mother from Maine. And as our Rayburn reports, court filings point to drugs and cash as the primary motivations for the murder of Krista Dittmeyer.
Investigators say this home on Route 16 in Ossipee is where Michael Patelis summoned Krista Dittmeyer via text message the night of April 22nd.
Once there, she was ambushed. She was struck in the head by Anthony Papil. She was then duct taped.
Police allege after that, Papil threw her in the trunk of her own car and with her baby daughter in the backseat, drove to Cranmore Mountain Resort.
Her body was then submerged into the pond that we call the snow pond.
Court documents indicate Trevor Ferguson, who marked his 23rd birthday that night, drove Papil back to Patelis' apartment. For his alleged role, investigators say Ferguson received drugs and about $20. Papil and Patelis are also accused of divvying up cash and drugs taken from Dittmeyer.
They're not men. They're animals.
Joseph Bennett, who lives a short distance behind Patelis' apartment, recorded these images as police divers searched the nearby Bear Camp River.
I told him that I heard a splash one night when I was over out back watching the beavers and the otters come up all the time, and it was an unnatural splash, but I saw no one around and didn't think of it, and then when I seen them dive, and I was like, oh.
Bennett and other neighbors believe police were looking for the rubber club Papil allegedly used to strike Dittmeyer. Members of the Dittmeyer family were in court to see those charged in connection with Krista's death, but they did not want to speak as they left to return to Maine.
I think it brings some closure, but I'm sure they'd rather have different circumstances.
Papil faces a second-degree murder charge, while Patelis and Ferguson are charged with conspiracy to commit robbery. Weeks after a Laconia woman died from a drug overdose, three people are now facing charges in connection to her death. Police say Ashley Denty died of acute heroin intoxication. Karen Meckelson and Stephen Mirando are accused of selling the drug that killed her. Amanda Kelly was also arrested in connection to the case. Police in Hudson are trying to track down those accused of stealing more than $30,000 worth of merchandise from Ayotte's Market. Police say one of the burglars removed his mask long enough to get caught on surveillance cameras, and anyone who recognizes this man is urged to contact Hudson Police. The right to work bill was dead in the water before it even hit Governor Lynch's desk. But yesterday morning, the governor made it official by vetoing that legislation that would give workers a choice on whether or not to pay union dues. House Republicans are confident that they have the support of the Senate and enough votes in the House to override the veto and make right to work a law in New Hampshire.
To be able to say to manufacturing companies, bring your jobs here, because this is a state where there's employer and employee freedom when it comes to unions, is going to be a great plus for this state.
Things are going quite well here in New Hampshire, and we shouldn't mess around with a strategy that we believe has been so successful. And right now we have a high-performing state economy, we have a relatively low unemployment rate, and we should be very glad with what we have here in New Hampshire and embrace the strategy that has made us so successful.
The override vote on right to work is scheduled for May 25th in the House. Meantime, a news conference is scheduled for today to explain the governor's veto and how this legislation would affect workers if it is enacted. And that's it for this webcast. We hope you can join us for more news later on. Take care and have a great day.